Germany's cyber defense agency is defending the way it handled a massive data leak. Personal information from hundreds of German politicians and celebrities was published online back in December, but only became public knowledge yesterday. And victims are demanding to know why. The cybersecurity body says it didn't alert them earlier because it wasn't able to connect the dots and didn't know the extent of the breach until yesterday. Now, the data was posted on a Twitter account over 4 weeks. The leak impacted politicians at all levels, including Chancellor Angela Merkel, Foreign Minister Heiko Maas, and Bundestag President Wolfgang Schäuble. In fact, there were very few politicians who weren't targeted. Most were from Merkel's Conservatives, the centre-left Social Democrats, the Left Party as well. The notable exception, the far-right AfD. The party confirmed yesterday that none of their lawmakers were affected. German authorities say the government's IT network was not compromised and they're looking at where the information came from. The intent remains unclear. Some politicians are demanding action. The UN's special envoy to Yemen has arrived in the country to try and shore up a ceasefire agreed upon last month. Since then, there have been reports of repeated violations of the truce, which applies to the port city of Hodeidah. This city is a crucial entry point for aid shipments and a lifeline for millions of Yemenis on the brink of starvation. Thousands of people have been protesting in the Hungarian capital Budapest today against what they're calling a slave labor law. It was passed just before Christmas and allows employers to demand hundreds of hours of overtime from their workers. Prime Minister Viktor Orbán's reforms have come under intense criticism and triggered repeated protests over the last several weeks. Now to some of the other stories making news around the world. There have been more clashes in Paris today, with thousands of so-called yellow vest protesters returning to the streets, calling for President Emmanuel Macron to step down. The protests began last year over a now scrapped fuel tax, but have grown into a broader uprising against falling living standards. There's been a delay to the announcement about who won last weekend's presidential election in the Democratic Republic of Congo. The Election Commission says so far it's received less than half of the ballots. Earlier this week, the Catholic Church said there was a clear winner and urged the result to be made public. A Polish city is in mourning after five teenage girls were killed in a fire. It happened while they were inside an escape room where people are locked in a room and have to solve clues to get out. Firefighters have blamed substandard safety procedures.